To understand the service mesh, we must first grasp the concept of microservices. Microservices architecture is a software architecture approach where an application is decomposed into several small services. Each service specializes in a single functionality. For instance, in an online shopping application, there would be different microservices for the user interface, the shopping cart, the homepage, the order history, the inventory, the payment, etc. Those microservices need to exchange data with each other. For example, when a user wants to purchase an item, the user interface communicates with the inventory to check if the product is in stock. If it is, the product can be added to the user's cart, and the user can proceed to payment. There are several ways to manage communications. The traditional way is to ask developers to code this logic within the microservice itself. The problem is that over time, this will become very time-consuming for developers to maintain this code. Indeed, in the long term, the number of microservices will increase, and developers will spend more and more time coding communication logic, which will become increasingly complex. And this is where the service mesh comes into play. A service mesh is a dedicated infrastructure layer that takes care of these inter-microservice communication functionalities. Service mesh is an infrastructure layer that sits between the application and the network via a proxy. As examples of service mesh implementations, we have Istio, Consul, and AWS App Mesh. As a result, developers are relieved of this work and can focus on tasks with higher added value, such as improving existing microservices or creating new ones. Now, let's see how the service mesh works. Firstly, each microservice is associated with a sidecar proxy, usually deployed in the same container. This concept of sidecar means these network proxies run alongside each service, rather than within the services. This sidecar, in front of each microservice, then becomes a mandatory passage for all incoming and outgoing calls to the service, and it will intelligently direct requests to other proxies. The data plane is a network of proxy sidecars attached to services. Then, the control plane is responsible for configuring and managing the sidecar proxies. It defines policies to implement usage rules, for example, which microservice can contact which microservice or dynamically limit traffic to a service. This central component also ensures security functionalities such as user authentication or communication encryption. Finally, there is often confusion between API gateway and service mesh. The main difference is that the API gateway manages traffic from outside the application to services inside the application, while the service mesh is a network service that facilitates communication between microservices internally. Thank you for watching this video. I trust you found it both informative and beneficial. Don't forget to subscribe to stay updated. Catch you in the next video. Until then, stay well.